Hello everyone and welcome back to another album review, and in this video I'm going to review Morning Tsunami by Hante. In the past I've already talked about Hante, and I've also talked about some of the releases in the project that she's part of called Minute Machine, which reunited and released Infrarouge, which for me was a pretty decent album in what it tried to achieve and just having basically some of the same sort of material that I would expect. So it hurt the album a bit that it was somewhat predictable, but still it offered some pretty good material. It's just that it didn't really grab my attention as much compared to their previous work. And so apart from that, even when it comes to the solo project of Hante, you basically know what to expect. We're just talking about your standard and usual approach on minimal wave and dark wave music, which made Fierce for me my personally least favorite work from her so far, but it was still a pretty nice project. I really enjoyed the album, and so the thing is that I got into this album expecting that I was going to like it. So yeah, I was pretty positive that we're just going to talk about another usual direction from Hante and another album that I'm going to find enjoyable. The thing is though that when it comes to Minute Machine, I was actually kinda surprised with the direction from the previous EP that they did, Don't Run From The Fire, which felt to have a few more EBM approaches, kinda become a bit more dark and slightly more aggressive, but still having the dark and melancholic atmosphere that you find in basically every work from Minute Machine. And so the thing with Morning Tsunami is that we're actually just talking about another usual release having what you would expect from Hante. But still, this is not a bad thing, because we're still getting, in my opinion, a really solid album. It's really good on what it does, and I would also argue that we might be talking about the darkest and the most sinister work from Hante so far. I mean, the dark atmosphere is something that you're basically getting with every single Hante work. This is not something unusual. However, I think that with this album in particular, it's kinda interesting because the eerie atmospheres and some of the sounds and the effects that are contained in this particular project are to a level that I don't really feel that we got this much in previous occasions. Just take example from the very first track, Apnée. It just starts with those really eerie and horror-esque vibes with all of those effects put together. However, when we're basically talking about the rest of the track, it's just another minimal wave song that, in my opinion, it's actually done in an awesome way. It's a really good song and definitely one of my favorites in the album, not only for its dark atmosphere, but also for the way it progresses. And we're also talking about a really lengthy song that doesn't really have vocals up until the second half. And this is something that actually happens a lot with this album in particular. It doesn't really focus that much on the vocals, and I kinda like that. Not because I don't enjoy Hante's vocals, but I think it's a really nice touch having some really big and lengthy moments that are just completely instrumental. And you have many occasions in this particular album where you might get zero vocals for almost half of the song. And some might argue that this might possibly hurt the experience in the sense that you're waiting for a build-up or that you're waiting to lead somewhere and it takes a while to come. And I would say that it happens at some occasions. The pacing can be a bit slow at times. You have tracks with introductions that feel lengthier than needed. And we're basically talking about an album that it's only 9 songs. And we're actually having some of the lengthiest tracks Hante has ever written. Some of them go for like 5 or 6 minutes, which is not that much of a usual length for tracks that go in a style like this, because they get easily repetitive. So it's mostly a matter of the melodies and the ideas on whether they manage to become captivating and keep your attention. In my opinion, the first leg of this album is a bit of a mixed bag, because I love songs like Apnée or Wasting Time. Wasting Time is another one of the most solid moments in the album for me. It has many sounds and ideas that in my opinion work so well together. But then you have tracks like Blank Love, for example, which I think it was one of the teasers. And for me, it's actually a pretty underwhelming choice for a teaser, because this is certainly for me the most underwhelming song out of this whole project. In the context of this album, it really feels forgettable, because I don't think that this track in particular manages to just really do something all that new, or just extend in the more dark and melancholic atmosphere that has already been creating. The pacing is a bit all over the place in my opinion, and it's the one song that I really didn't enjoy. So yeah, for me, kind of a weird choice for a teaser track, because if I were to get into this album listening to this at first, I would possibly go with lower expectations. This is not one of my favorite Hunt moments. There is also the track Transparent, which could lead to an interesting idea, but it's just basically an interlude. It's only 2.5 minutes, and it could lead somewhere, but it's more of just like wasted potential. The second leg of this album though has some of the most interesting ideas in the entire project for me, with the biggest highlight being the track A Lifetime of Desires. Honestly, it's another one of those tracks that in my opinion really works amazingly with this sort of new direction that this album of Hunt goes, having this more dark attitude and also having those sounds and those effects that just help of creating a more eerie and sort of creepy atmosphere. It's a really dark song, and it's one of the best when it comes to its ideas and its melodies. It's really memorable and definitely one of my favorite Hunt songs, period. Other than that, there are also the two tracks Catharsis and Coming Home, which for me serve as great finishers. They're two really solid moments. Not something though that really stands out for them in terms that they don't really do something different compared to what were basically used for Hante. And I cannot stress this enough, but there is nothing basically all that new or different that I have to really say about this album other than that. So this basically leads to a somewhat shorter view of a Hante album, because I've addressed many of the characteristics that make Hante or Minute Machine such great artists, and for me this is just another solid release. It might end up becoming my least favorite Hante project, but this is still one that I enjoyed a lot. I like that in some occasions the album got into some darker tones, and once again, another album with many great songs about it. Definitely recommended for fans of Hunter and Minimal Wave in general. I'm going to give Morning Tsunami a 7 out of 10. What's your opinion on this album? Like it, dislike it, why, and what do you want me to review next time? Let me know down in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe for more content like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.